first, Miss Wallace. You know, I've been knowing Miss Wallace for years. You chose not to cast an actress to play her. Mm-hmm. She's in the movie. And I don't want to give it away for anybody who hasn't seen it. So I'm trying to phrase my questions appropriately so that I don't give anything away. But I love the fact that you had her come in. She plays herself. And I love just as much, although the movie's clearly about Biggie, you chose not to focus. You know, he's in it, but he's blurred. He's only, the movie doesn't center around an actor playing Biggie.
Yeah.
And I also noticed you have a lot of real Biggie interviews, Biggie music. So you were committed to not just telling a true story, but within the movie, the people who took part, meaning Miss Wallace and Biggie through his voice and his interviews, he's in it.
Yeah.
Why those choices? Why was that so important to you?
I remember I took a meeting. They were interested. I don't know how I even got the meeting. They were interested in me for the Tupac movie. And Singleton had become a mentor of mine. And I had then found out that John was going to do the movie. And I was like, no, John, you have to do the movie. Like, you're the guy, right? And then John's like, nah, man, it's all political. They're going to screw up Pac's legacy. They're going to ruin it. Like, I'm not doing it. And I was like, well, I'm not doing it if you're not doing it. And then I just politely bowed out. I never got the job offer, but I was in the conversation and I just said it wasn't for me. Later, John reengaged, which I was really happy about because I felt for Pac's legacy, that would be the right thing. And it didn't end up going that way. And they went in a different direction years later. But at the time, I was really stressed because I felt outside of John and just in my own head, nobody can make a Pac movie better than me. Like, I'm going to murder this thing. But I was really stressed over, like, how corny and cheesy it feels when, like, we watch these actors portray, like, Pac and in this instance Biggie, and like, you just can't recreate these human beings. I don't care how much they look like them or this like them. Like, I don't know. It's such a slippery slope. And I felt that I wanted to keep the authenticity of these young men and pay homage to them and humanize them and not mess with something that would be what we typically see in that regard. And I think that always stuck in my head a little bit from that experience of that interview and me sweating, how am I going to pull this off? What does that look like? And, you know, cause I don't know. I mean, like, there's only one Tupac Shakur. There's only one Christopher Wallace. Like, I don't know. So when I went into this, there are iconic things about the way Biggie moved and, you know, his size and the gold chain on that last night, that I felt we could utilize them to capture them. And then we have Miss Wallace tells the story of the clock of life. And I thought I tried to feel that it would be powerful to lay over that voice to bring the presence of his mom, because he's basically walking, which he doesn't know, to his death. And how heartbreaking this is, but the strength that Miss Wallace shows. And then in the car, you know, I was like, well, we got to get Biggie's audio in here. So I, like, you know, I recreated those conversations, you know, with his real audio. I wanted to bring him and his humanity and his presence into the movie. Same thing. The really famous DJ or on-air personality, I'm blanking. He was on stage at the Nas concert and they did a moment of silence for Pac when he had passed. And so I dropped that in so we could have a moment of silence for Pac in the middle of the movie.
What are we talking? Is that Ed Lover?
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, Ed Lover. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Ed Lover.
Yeah, and you hear the gasp from the audience. And it's just, I have chills now telling you, because it's just like the power of how these men, you know, and impacted individuals across the universe. They're universal icons. I did not want to mess with that. And so that's why when I had been familiar with the Ed Lover, thank you for clarifying that, because you know, moment of silence for Pac. I was like, I have to have that in there. I want to pay homage to Pac in a small way. I want to have that moment of silence in the movie. And those photographs, because I had done some other stuff creatively, the Pac estate said, we would prefer you do it differently for their reasons. I said, no problem. And they said, because see, they didn't make any money. They weren't involved. I went to them and said, I want to show you the movie before it's released to see, make sure that you are okay with everything in the film and you have no problems with the film. Because I couldn't, you know, Pac left his legacy to them. And I felt like the best way that I can honor him was to respect his wishes and not exploit off his name, because we have something about Tupac Shakur in our movie and his murder. So Tom Wally and Molly, they were like, we would like this change, this change, this change. I was like, no problem, I'll change anything. And they were really appreciative. So they gave me those photographs of Pac, which is how they made the movie at that point in time in that particular place in the film. So all of this was just a unique journey. But yeah, I hope that it works for people. And I hope they understand that I wasn't trying to do anything other than honor them. But because it's about the murders of these men, and as you said eloquently, this, you know, Biggie being slain, I think if we start trying to fictionalize who they are in the movie on every side, from his mom to that, then maybe we start undermining what this movie is really supposed to be for me and hopefully for the rest of the audience. This is a movie that I want you to understand lives in truth. It's not just a movie. It's bigger than that. This is a true story in that regard. So I wanted to hit it hard that way. And if you just start fictionalizing everything, then I don't know if the gravity of the loss of life sticks for you. Because at the end of the movie, when I show the image of Pac and Big together, like, that's the cats you were following through the whole movie. Absolutely. Not just some actors. So.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.